welcome to the seventh day of the Spanish part of the 2015 Winter Universiade, the sights of the Sierra Nevada proving to be just as spectacular at night as they are by day. On the menu, the figure skating comes to a climax with the traditional gala taken to the ice of the Granada Igloo. Over 4,500 fans cram into the Granada Sport Palace to see host Spain take on Slovakia in the men's ice hockey. And in the men's curling, Norway put their 6-0 record on the line against a Canadian quartet that's really coming into form. We start at the Universiade Igloo, and with the serious figure skating now done and dusted, it was time for the traditional end of event gala, giving a chance for the medal winners from this Universiade to really let their hair down in front of a full house of really appreciative fans. Maria Artemieva from Russia won the bronze medal in the ladies' competition here in Granada. She decided to treat the crowd to a dance to Siempre Me Cadera by Bebe, showing all of the artistry that took her to that bronze medal, with a personal best in the free program in the ladies' competition. Also a personal best for her overall total as well. Warm appreciation then from the crowd in the Granada Igloo. Romé Berenice Agnete from France just pipped Artemieva to the silver medal in the ladies' competition. Just over a point in it between the two. The 20-year-old French champion for the last couple of years. 10th at last year's Olympics as well. This time dancing to Tchaikovsky's Swan Lake. Beautifully done by the University of Montpellier student. Sara Hurtado and Edira Diaz of Spain won the silver medal in the ice dance competition. They previously finished fourth in the 2011 Universiade and then eighth 2 years ago in Trentino. They came into this competition hot on the heels of a fifth place finish at this year's European Championships. The opportunity to show off a few moves that they certainly wouldn't get away with in a serious ice dance competition. Dancing to Stay With Me from Sam Smith. This on the same night that Sam Smith won four Grammys, including two for Best Song and Best Record for that very number. And now to the winner from the ladies' event, Elena Leonova from Russia. Declared herself delighted with her Universiade debut, deciding to have a little dance to Shakira, always a good choice to get a largely Spanish crowd going. The former world junior champion, delighted with her Universiade debut. She said, "I came to give the best of myself, to try and be the best." And she certainly did exactly that. Great rhythm from the 24-year-old, and a lovely finish as well. Ryu Zhaoyu and Jin Yang from China won the gold in the pairs competition in 2015. A team with great pedigree, this time dancing to the rather familiar strains of Nessan Dorma. As a pair, they won the 2012 Junior Winter Olympics as well as the 2014 Junior World Championships. This season, David Wilton replacing Marina Zueva as their choreographer. It certainly seems to have paid dividends here in Granada. Peter Liebers of Germany won gold in the men's event, the first German ever to win a medal in his event, let alone the gold. Kleber's sixth in the European Championship just over a week ago, as he was in 2014. Dancing to Status Quo's Whatever You Want. What he wanted was a gold medal, and that's exactly what he got. Status Quo always popular with the crowds. Lieber's putting on a fine show. Well, finally, Charline Guignard and Marco Fabbri won the gold in the ice dance. This time dancing to Canto della Terra, a duet performed by Sarah Brightman and Andre Bocelli. A fitting way to bring the curtain down on a fantastic figure skating gala in the igloo in Granada. So a fitting finale to the figure skating competition here in Spain, and greatly appreciated too by the packed crowd. Russia, China, Germany and Italy with a gold apiece in the figure skating competition, while the igloo itself now has a day to transform itself into the venue that will host the thrills and spills from the short track speed skating competition from now until the end of the week. Now to the Granada Sport Palace, where a full house of 4,500 fans were in attendance as host Spain faced off against Slovakia. At stake, second place in Group A and a place in the quarterfinals. The Spaniards started the tournament with a rousing 8-0 thrashing of group whipping boys China before going down to a gallant 5-2 defeat at the hands of group winners the Czech Republic. A partisan crowd hoping for a return to their form from that opening match. However, the Slovakians have plenty of Universiad pedigree, champions in 2001, as well as picking up silver medals in 1999 and 2003, and a bronze in 2009. They got off to a rocky start here in Granada, though, with a 6-3 loss at the hands of their Czech neighbours, but a 13-1 blowout of the Chinese in their second match gave them a welcome confidence boost ahead of this game, avoiding the lottery of the playoffs, a must for Andre Vibo's team. The Slovaks immediately on the offensive though. Denis Nosiar with an early wrist shot, but well held by Ander Alkane, who's really impressed during this tournament. However, just 3 minutes were on the clock when the Slovaks took the lead. Denis Mihailik with the puck on the left and passing across to the rapidly arriving Unak, who flicked home his third goal of the tournament. The Spanish showing some good skating skills though, and they got back on level terms in the 11th minute. Alejandro Carbonell's shot spilled by Juraj Halo. The loose puck then tucked into the net by Javier Garcia Aniath, his second goal in three games. The Slovaks unable to get back into the lead in the opening period, with Arkane once again proving his worth. Into the second period, and a rare shot from the Spanish, Gaston Gonzalez trying his luck from over on the left wing, but seeing that shot whistle past the post. The Slovaks, meanwhile, continuing to rain shots on the Spanish goal. Jan Padavi's shot here, deflected over the crossbar by Alkane. The Slovak team, mostly bigger and stronger than their Spanish opponents too. Tomas Rosina here sending his opposite number, Paul Gonzalez, flying into the net, ripping it off of its moorings. Slovakia eventually back into the lead midway through the period. Rosina taking advantage of a change of lines to race clear and then open his personal account here in Granada. The floodgates rather opening after that. 3 minutes later and 2-1 became 3-1. Patricio Fuentes paying the price for dallying over the puck in front of his own net. He was dispossessed by Matas Trenkan, with the puck eventually bundled into the net by team captain Edmund Piaka. There was even time for another goal before the break. Peter Gapa credited with his third goal of the tournament, but the replay is showing the puck taking a slight deflection off the stick of Pardavi, and maybe a defenseman too. Certainly enough to leave Alkane stranded in the Spanish net. Slovakia then carrying on where they left off as the third period got underway. Padavi finding space on the right before hitting the post, and then moments later changing tack, this time cutting inside, before this time hitting a shot against the chest of Alkane. The Slovaks deservedly then extended their lead in the 45th minute of the match. Mihajlik finding space behind the net and finding the pass to Niklas Kentner, who swept in his second goal in Spain with the keeper Alkane unsighted. The Spanish finally getting forward as the clock wound down. Juan Munoz seeing his first shot blocked and his second stab well saved, with Adrian Beltran only able to steer the rebound into the body of the prone Hallo. However, the Spaniards had finally grabbed their second goal of the night on a late power play. Just 5 seconds left on the clock and Munoz set up Alejandro Pedraz. His shot well parried, but Fuentes was then on hand to put away the rebound for his second goal of the group stage, bringing the scores back to 5-2. And that's how it ended. The Slovaks, the more clinical of the sides in front of goal, and deserving that 5-2 victory, enough to put them safely into the last eight here in Granada. Those three goals in the second period proving to be the difference between the two sides. The golfing class reflected by the shot count too, 59-29 in Slovakia's favour. And they'll now hope to use that momentum in the quarterfinals, where they'll be up against the rather inconsistent Russian side on Wednesday. While Spain will now fall into the playoff system, where they'll fancy their chances against South Korea. Lastly, we go to the Fuentenueva Pavilion for the seventh round of matches from the men's curling competition, featuring Norway against Canada. The Norwegians, far and away the class of the field so far here in Granada, having won their first six matches in a row. Meanwhile, Canada had only won one of their first four matches. Since then, they've beaten a very handy Russian quartet and Spain. They're now with a 3-3 record, but still needing to kick on from here. Well, the Norwegians are the single in the first end. Now we go to the second, the last stone from the Norwegians. Just trying to use the Canadian stone to stay in the house. Unfortunately, just too thin a contact, sliding out to the side. So Matt Dunstan, the Canadian skip, and with a simple draw for a double in the second end. No mistakes made there. And so Norway into a 2-1 lead after two ends. The Norwegians then taking a single again in the third to make it 2-2. We move to the fourth end now, the last stone, this time from Stefan Volstad. He was the number three for Norway 2 years ago in Trentino. Just looking to draw around the front guard, fortunately clipping it instead. Potentially disastrous for the Norwegians. The Canadians already sitting two with a chance to make it three. But this also a very dangerous shot. The wrong contact on those two scoring stones could push them out. A little tentative with the pace, plenty of sweeping going on, but it's not going to be enough. So afraid of disturbing those stones by the button. Canadians leaving that one way short. Still good enough for a pair and a 4-2 lead after four ends. The Norwegians again taking a single in the fifth for a 4-3 Canada lead. We now move to the sixth end. The last Norwegian stone again. Here with a simple takeout to sit two. But leaving a good opportunity here for Matt Dunstan. All he needs is a full contact on that scoring Norwegian stone. The right pace, the right line, the right result. That's another pair for Canada and a 6-3 lead. Into the seventh end then. The Norwegians with the hammer now. It's the last Dunstan stone of the end, trying a double takeout. Just hitting the side of that first Norwegian stone, though. His own stone also sliding out of the back of the house. Volstadt. Fairly simple task here to score Norway's first double of the match. The sweeper's happy with the line and the length. So another two for Norway, bringing the scores back to 6-5 Canada. Three ends left, moving to the eighth end now. And the last of the Norwegian stones, just trying to draw around the left guard, just in front of the house. But another mistake here from Volstadt. Clipping that stone instead. And that, a potential game changer. Dunstan slides in with plenty of pace on this one. Simple takeout, he could score three. There's the contact. Canadian stone staying in range as well. So a triple for Dunstan. A 9-5 Canadian lead with just two ends left to go into the ninth then. The last Canadian stone. Really just a case of damage limitation. Not really worried about trying to win the end. Taking that Norwegian stone out. So Volstadt with a simple draw to the button for a pair. Plenty of work going into this stone as well, but it would get there in the end. Sweeper's now relaxing. That one right on the button indeed. So the Canadian lead chopped back to 9-7, but Dunstan with the hammer in the 10th and final end. This the last stone coming from Volstadt. Trying to draw this one in onto the button so that the Norwegians can lie the two shots that they need. This stone though, not quite going to get the job done. Just a little bit too far to the right. That stone scoring, but he's nudged his other one out of the way. And that enough for the Norwegians. Canada going to a 4-3 record thanks to a 9-7 victory. The Norwegians, though, already in the semi-finals with a 6-1 record.
Well, you're a real tough cookie with a long history of breaking little hearts like the one on me. Hit me with your best shot. Why don't you hit me with your best shot? Hit me with your best shot. Fire away. Hit me with your best shot. Why don't you hit me with your best shot? Hit me with your best shot. Fire
education meets sport and culture. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.